Let's go back to the next item. It is a theorem about the zeros, which is a preliminary to this Weierstrass factorization theorem, which we will see tomorrow, I guess. Theorem by Hurwitz. By the way, okay, Nico climbed to 1916 last time, and here we are back in the 19th century. This theorem says that, okay, suppose that I have polymorphic functions Fn. So suppose I have holomorphic functions, polymorphic in some omega, where Fn is different than zero for Z. And Fn converges to F uniformly on convex sets. then only two things can happen. The first one is that F is identically zero in omega, and the second is that F of Z is F is zero free. So we cannot, unlike with real functions, of course, we can cook up real functions having just, converging to a function which has maybe some isolated zeros. With the holomorphic functions, it's not possible. That's the content of Hurwitz theorem. Right. Now, suppose by contradiction, suppose that the limit function is not identically zero, and it is zero at some point. Here, omega is connected, omega connected, open connected. If it's not connected, of course, I can make it zero, one connected component, and different than zero, some other one. Right. Okay, if zero, if not identically zero, it means that I can make it different than zero for mod z minus z naught less than some r, because zeros are isolated. And just to make a correction because of my note. Here it is. Okay, and now we estimate. So when we consider 1 over Fn of z for such z, 1 over Fz, which is like f of z and z over f n of z times f z, and that's less or equal, say, object. If I consider, now draw a picture, if I consider Z minus Z naught is equal to R, let me put here less or equal than R, and n greater or equal than some constant, that's less or equal than f of z minus fn of z. And below, I can consider the minimum of f w square, say over 2, as w minus z naught. Is equal to R. So I'm doing the estimate here. R. And if I let n to infinity, the last quantity goes to zero uniformly. On this circle over there. By Weierstrass, we have that f prime n of z goes to f of prime of z uniformly on complex sets. In particular, uniformly for z minus z naught is equal to R, the one of the picture. So, when you consider the limit as n goes to infinity of 1 over 2 pi I, and here we consider f prime n of z over f n of z dz, z minus z naught is equal to r. But these are two facts. But this fact, this fact, it's easy to see that this is 1 over pi integral z minus z naught is equal to r of f of z over f prime of z dz. Well, but this we know, it's the limit of the number of the roots of f of z is equal to zero in inside z minus z naught is equal to r, and this is the number that's fn of the roots. Same thing for f. F of z is equal to zero inside z minus z naught is equal to r. And our assumption was that that was zero by hypothesis. Well, I guess then, I don't know why I used the contradiction. Well, and that's equal to one. That zero is equal to zero. That's a contradiction. Okay. Here you check the details. Check that these two uniform things divided 1 over fn goes uniformly to f prime. Ah, yeah, well, it's the product of two uniformly convergent things. Okay. That's the end of it. So, let me tell you an application to infinite products. So what? Does it say about products? What it says is this one. Consider, so suppose, well, say omega is connected, open, connected. Connected. Fn is a holomorphic in omega. And consider P of Z product for n 1 to infinity of fn z. So if p converges uniformly on a compact set, so I can use Hurwitz theorem, then p that is equal to zero only if there exists n, so that fn set is equal to zero. So we have the infinite version of the factorization theorem, which is not true in general, which is not general. Okay. Now I would say I will state Weierstrass factorization. And then tomorrow we prove, let me see if we can manage to do everything. Yes. And then tomorrow we prove Weierstrass factorization and Mittag-Leffler theorem. So so here we have Weierstrass. So what is the problem? So the problem, so suppose, that that a n are the zeros on of F, a holomorphic function, entire function. Then we would like define, we would like the product for n 1 to infinity. Say that all of them are different than zeros. And of course, we know since they have an accumulation point, they must be converged to something. So what we'd like to, we'd like this product one minus z over a n. Let me call it little p. Yes. AN to converge. To converge. But this is the same as asking sum for n 1 to infinity of logarithm 1 minus z over an converges. And if I want this, just to make things easy, absolutely. It is the same as asking sum for n to infinity of 1 over over a n to converge. Absolutely. And this is the problem. Okay? Which in general is not true. Which is not true. General. So the idea is to replace the idea that we see tomorrow, it is to make a better Taylor expansion. So to use the fact that the logarithm of 1 minus w, principal determination or whatever it is, can be written like this, but can also be written as with a better approximation. So logarithm. So let's say logarithm of 1 minus w minus that polynomial over m, let's call it phi m of w, that's very small, rho, sorry, rho. That's kind of very small as w goes to zero. And taking exponentials, it means that 1 minus w times e to the minus w plus Wm over m, it's e to the rho m w is very close to 1. Because the rho is very close to 0. So instead of the naive 1 minus z over an, we will put 1 minus z over an times e to the minus z over an plus z 1 over some number that in general will depend on n times z over A-N-M. Okay. Let's call this like E-M-N. What's that over A-N? And instead of these products, we'll consider products for n point infinity of is E M N set A N with these numbers M N properly chosen. Properly chosen. Instead of products of one minus. Okay. And then we see tomorrow how to let. And we use a similar idea to deal with the use a similar idea to deal with the interpolation problem. That's a theorem by Mittag-Leffler.